Hello and welcome to this digital poster session. My name is Bianca Lassen-Schmidt and I'm from Fraunhofer MeVis. Today I would like to show you our preliminary study for lobe segmentation with a 3D unit. First, I would like to give you a few basic information about lung anatomy because it is important to understand our problem and our approach. Human lungs can be subdivided into five lobes. There are two lobes on the left side and three lobes on the right side. The lobes have separated supply branches for vessels and airways. On a CT, you can see bright lines between the lobes. It is called fissure. If you see the fissure, you can see the lobar boundaries. But fissures can be incomplete or sometimes completely missing. We developed many years on a watershed-based segmentation for the lobes. It works quite well, but has limitations. For cases with severe diseases, the results could be better. Therefore, we trained a 3D unit for lobe segmentation. It was only a preliminary study with only a few data sets. But the first impression was the segmentation results are not bad, but the segmentation could be a bit more accurate at the lobar boundaries. So our challenge was to improve the 3D unit to be more accurate at the lobar boundaries. And I will show you our approach now. How can we bring the unit to pay more attention to the lobar boundaries? Our idea was to add a weighted dice loss to the unit training. The weight should be on the lobar boundaries, but the reference segmentation that we use for the training, validation and testing can also be a little bit inaccurate. Thus, if we would set a weight only on the boundaries, the actual fissure might be on the neighboring voxels and would not be regarded in this case. Therefore, we calculate a gradient around the lobar boundaries by an Euclidean distance transformation. We invert the result to get high values, in our case 10, at the lobar boundaries. Within a distance of 10 mm, the weight is descending up to 1. The rest of the lungs has a weight of 1 as well. We train two separate units, one unit for each lung, as you can see here. Training input are the CT scans, or actually a bounding box with the CT scan. The lobe labels, 3 for the right lung and 2 for the left lung, and the weighting gradient images. It is a preliminary study because we only had 70 labeled CT scans. We decided to use 49 for training, 7 for validation, and 14 data sets for testing. Let's come to the results. We compared our results with two other methods. Our first comparison method is our watershed-based lobe segmentation that includes information from bronchi, vessels and fissures. The second method is our unit without weighting. Our goal was to improve our unit at the visible fissures, therefore our evaluation metric is the distance from the visual fissures to the segmented lobar boundaries. In this plot, you can see the average surface distances from the fissures for all three methods. What you can see is that the median distance for two methods is comparable. That is the watershed method on the left side, and this plot is called auto method, and the here proposed unit with weighting on the right side. In comparison to the watershed, both methods, both units, showed outliers. The most important thing that you can see in this plot is that the median distance is lower for the unit with weighting in comparison to the unit without weighting. This is with without weighting, and this is with weighting. So our weighted dice loss improved the unit. Finally, we come to the summary and outlook. Today we have presented you our 3D unit for lung lobe segmentation. The novelty is a weighted dice loss with a gradient weight. We compared the method to two other approaches and could show that the weighted loss function improved the segmentation quality. But this is only a preliminary study. We had this idea and wanted to test it on a few data sets. In the near future, we want to include large data sets for training and we want to do an extensive evaluation regarding pathologies and including more evaluation metrics. Thank you for your attention in this online poster session. Please feel free to ask questions or to contact us.